How are you, grade 5 learners? We are still in fourth quarter, and this is week 6, presentation and interpretation of data in a line graph with problem solving. After going through this lesson, you are expected to organize data in tabular form and presents them in a line graph. Interprets data presented in different kinds of line graphs, like single to double line graph. Solves routine and non-routine problems using data presented in a line graph, and draws inferences based on data presented in a line graph. Data gathered and organized can be presented in tabular form. For a clearer representation, it can be presented in a graph. One of these is the line graph. The line graph has a vertical line called y-axis, which contains the first variable in the collected data. It may represent almost any type of numerical data, such as pesos, scores, number of people, temperature, grades, etc. On the other hand, the horizontal line called x-axis in the line graph contains the second variable that relates to the first variable in the collected data. As we go to the right in the x-axis, time, periods, or names of things being compared are enumerated. Let us try to solve the following examples. Example 1. Karin recorded her daily expenses in school for a week. She spent 25 pesos on Monday, 30 pesos on Tuesday, 10 pesos on Wednesday, 60 pesos on Thursday, and 35 pesos on Friday. Let us organize the data in a tabular form and present them in a line graph. Fill up the table with the correct data. Here is the table. What are the procedure in constructing a line graph? First, draw the lines for the x-axis and y-axis. Second, label the x-axis with the days following the proper order from Monday to Friday. Third, for the expenses with 10 as an interval, label the y-axis from 0 to 70, increasing order as you go up. Fourth, plot the points that correspond to the day and expenses. For Monday, 25 pesos. Tuesday, 30 pesos. Wednesday, 10 pesos. Thursday, 60 pesos, and Friday, 35 pesos. Fifth, connect the points by a line segment. And last, number 6, put a title for the graph. Meanwhile, Karin's sister, Carla, also had recorded her daily expenses, and you will see it on the table below. Example 2. Draw a line graph for the given data above. Again, procedure in constructing a double line graph. Draw the line for the x-axis and y-axis. Second, label the x-axis with the days following the proper order from Monday to Friday. Third, for the expenses with 10 as an interval, label the y-axis from 0 to 70, increasing order as you go up. Fourth, plot the points that correspond to Karin and Carla's daily expenses and draw a new line segment, preferably in another color. For Karin, for Monday, 25, Tuesday, 30 pesos, Wednesday, 10 pesos, Thursday, 60 pesos, and Friday, 35 pesos. While for Carla, on Monday, 20 pesos, Tuesday, 25 pesos, Wednesday, 15 pesos, Thursday, 50 pesos, and Friday, 30 pesos. In addition, there must be a legend as to go which line segment belongs to Karin and Carla for proper identification. So legends, black line for Karin and red line for Carla. Fifth, connect the points by a line segment. For Karin, for Carla, and last, number 6, put a title for the graph. A line graph is a visual comparison of how two variables shown on the x and y axis are related or varies with each other. It is useful in displaying data or information that changes continuously over time. The points on a line graph are connected by a line. 5 parts of the line graph must be present for the graph to be complete. Title, scale, labels, points, and line. Example 3. Below is an example of a line graph. Study its parts and answer some of the questions below. What is the title of the line graph? What information is placed along the vertical axis on the horizontal axis? For vertical axis, enrollment, and horizontal axis, grade level. What grade level has the largest enrollment in 2019? The largest enrollment, kindergarten and grade 3. How about the least? grade 2. How many is the combined enrollment of kindergarten and grade 3? Add enrollment of kindergarten and grade 3. 400 enrollees. Example 4. Let us go back and compare Karin and Carla's graph of expenses in school by referring to the graph below, and let us answer the questions that follow. What is the title of the graph? Karin and Carla's daily expenses in school. What does the scale in the y-axis represent? It represents the amount of their daily expenses. In which day or days were Carla's expenses greater than Karin's? Wednesday. What is the difference between their expenses on Friday? 5 pesos. For your learning task number 1, use the graph at the right to answer the questions below. What is the title of the graph? Comparison of plant growth. What does the scale in y-axis represent? Height in centimeters. How about number 3? What is the height of plant A and plant B at day 2? Which plant shows great increase in height? Why? What happened to the plant near the window? For learning task number 2, grade 5 Aris of Gatid Elementary School held their class elections last Monday. For the position of secretary, Scarlett, Jelaine and Karin were nominated. In their class of 30 pupils, they gained the number of votes. Scarlett 9, Jelaine 5, Karin 14. Organize the data in table and answer the questions that follow. For Scarlett 9 votes, Jelaine 5 votes, Karin 14 votes. How many grade 5 pupils voted for the election of secretary in grade 5 Aris? What is the total number of votes gained by Jelaine and Karin? What is the difference in the number of Karin's and Scarlett's votes? How about number 4? If there is a total of 30 pupils in grade 5 Aris, how many pupils did not vote? If all the students were present last Monday, who do you think will win the election for secretary? Present the votes of the nominees using line graph. Use the rubric below in giving scores for the graph. For learning task number 3, study the graph, then answer the questions that follow. What is the difference in height of seedlings at day 5 as compared to day 2? What is asked? What facts are needed to solve the problem? Try to answer number 3. What operation will you use? What is the number sentence? What is the complete answer? Mildred has an inventory for her daily sales of ice candy. For Monday, 300 pesos. Tuesday, 250 pesos. Wednesday, 150 pesos. Thursday, 250 pesos. And Friday, 500 pesos. Using this inventory data, help Mildred organize them in a tabular form. For Monday, 300 pesos. Tuesday, 250 pesos. Wednesday, 150 pesos. Thursday, 250 pesos. And Friday, 500 pesos. Use the data in the table to construct a line graph. Use the rubric below in giving scores for the graph. Using this table, let us construct a line graph. First, the x-axis and the y-axis. Then, days from Monday to Friday. Amount in peso with an interval of 100 pesos. Next, plot the point for Monday, 300 pesos. Tuesday, 250 pesos. Wednesday, 150 pesos. Thursday, 250 pesos. And Friday, 500 pesos. Next, connect the point by line segment. And last, put the title. Answer the following questions. What day Mildred has the lowest sale? What days she has same amount of sales? What is Mildred's total sale from Monday to Friday? Shout out nga pala kay We Asli Cabral from Cabuyao, Laguna. Maraming salamat muli sa pagsama niyo sa atin sa ating video. Kung nagustuhan niyo ang ating video, please like and subscribe at pindutin na rin ang notification bell para updated kayo sa mga bago pang darating na videos. Pwede kayong mag-comment at syempre, please share this to your classmates. Hanggang sa muli, paalam!